Well, first of all, you just came back from a tour. Where were you?
Well, in England, yeah. I was in America first, and then after America, I went to England.
Yeah. I know the tour in America, I hear, was Sly and the Family Stone. What was it like working with them?
Great, yeah. Yeah, we had a fun tour with Sly, and I do some show with him and thing till after a while. We never finished most about three of the show then. Because we'd have some date on our own, you know.
Yeah.
So it's really good with that.
Yeah. Listen, now the time has come when you are going on tours with people like Sly and the Family Stone. I mean, these are people that we hear about in Jamaica. And when you hear the name, you know they're big stars. When you perform on the same bill with people like that, do you feel any different from when you perform in Jamaica on your own?
Well, right now, the difference in feelings, you know, right now, I don't really feel no difference. We just want to play good music and play good music. Mm-hmm. So I don't care which part of the music I play. Because it's not the people who I play music, you know.
Yeah.
So we just love to play good music.
Yeah. Now, Bob, but have you at all made any changes in the way you play your music when you go to America, or you just play it same like you play it here?
Well, tell you the truth, the music where I play, well, are the music where I would like to play, is a music where it's playing in Jamaica, but never really get the full understanding and the music where me play, or the music. Because the next, you know, from now on, is my music will play now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Of course, you know, this business about you being popular in England nowadays. You just told me you're on the cover of Rolling, of what magazine in England this week? One of the music magazines?
I use Melody Maker, yeah.
All right, so you're on the cover of Melody Maker in Britain. That must mean they think a great deal of you. You know, critics write about your records and all that sort of thing. Do you think this is the point that you wanted to reach? Or what exactly is the point you want to get to in music?
Well, the point is the fulfillment of revelation. And I man don't say it's my work for going to Babylon, to really do what I do. But I find myself doing it and I can't stop it because greater power than the power I know of myself. Make I do it. And then I find no arm come to eye. So I do it. But the real thing is that his imperial majesty, Emperor Selassie I, is earth rightful ruler. And I man is a citizen of the earth. And Zion is Ethiopia. You know? Well, I don't know if it's my work for going to Babylon to really get the youths together. But I find myself in a farm where if I have understanding or overstanding, I can see. It really had to do something towards something, you know? And it's revelation now.
Yeah. Now, Bob, could we talk a little bit about you and how you started out in the singing business? I know you started very young. How did you start?
Started out crying.
Right from the start.
Yeah,
eh?
Started out crying, yeah. You know? And then music becomes a part. Our music is a part, I was a part, you know. But to tell you how it really started, is really a thing when I really have to think about how it really started, because I can't be ungrateful to Jah. Mm-hmm. Because today we start, yet it was yesterday, you know. Mm-hmm. So from the beginning, Jah created, you know, the starting for the man start.
Yeah.
Know what I mean? So really have to think about from creation then.
All right, well, okay, let's get it down to this sort of terms now. When did you first go in a studio? Or somebody got you in a studio, or you went on a stage show or something, perform in public?
About 1960.
Yeah. No, what is that? You went in a studio to record?
No, go
a stage show.
Question, yes. Question. Them used to have like a thing down at Queens, there, you know. So one night I'm going to go sing a tune and win a pound. And the man them tell us I must start sing.
Right away.
Because them time I used to down Darling Street and Sartley on a back of wall and them place there, you know. Among some brethren who know the right but get brutalized by just saying right things, you know what I mean?
Yeah. You know, Bob, it seems to me you always seem to come back to the situation when you talk, that you're always aware of the suffering. It seems to me that is you keep coming right back to it all the time. I would you say you're a bitter person or angry or you know?
Well, I'm on sight of earth today, Neville. And when I'm on sight of earth, I know say people live off a false pretense, majority of them, you know. And I know say I and I don't have to suffer the way always suffer. Not because of material things, but in some way material things becomes an object we make I and I have to suffer. And through the people and the teaching where them get, and them want to come teach with the same teaching, the whole wine where them get, and we show them the truth today. And so them fight against the truth because them say, well then, because of this self-pride and respect, because you're older than me, I shouldn't come tell you something where you should have known long, long time ago. So you use this false pride and fight me down, because when I tell you about Rastafari, through your long experience you are from time ago about the teaching where you get, you can't see this not even a new wine, this is creation, you know. Mm-hmm. But you can't see something where them don't teach you, only have to see where them teach you.
Yeah.
So it's not angry and all of that, but it's just truth, you know, and then it have to bust out a man like a river.
Right. And your way to bust it out is in your music. That's the way it comes out. That's how,
that's
your expression.
So talk, yeah.
All right. Listen now, you talk about material things, right? But, Bob, quite frankly, I don't think you would fairly say that right now you are a sufferer in the sense of money.
Well, if you check what money is, then money don't make you suffer, and money don't make you don't suffer. Hey, everything really rests in your mind, you know, because I dig this.
Yeah.
I man's a farmer, you know. And I man don't live with money. Them could have never give you a penny, I see. I man have to live. You know, but again, you know, I man can play music, and I man don't fear it for the earth. So I man play music, and if money for come out of music, don't it come out of music, I don't know my directly. My heart really opened wide, I bleed blood for get money.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, right.
For
right,
the thing
right.
is, Selassie I is the king of kings on earth. No, which guy on earth rich like the king of kings? So my father is the richest man on earth, so I man a rich man. Mm-hmm. But then I mind, because I suffer on you because, you know, on you. Because not material things make you suffer, you know, because just them never give a man more than him can bear. That means yes, a man tell me, say, yes, them never drink no tea and the other day never drink no tea, because I know if the man that want to drink tea, he could have drink tea.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's the mind things, you know.
Yeah. You know, it's fantastic, you know. I mean, a lot of people listen to popular music, right? They listen to records. And if they're not, if some people just listen to it and all of them hear is a rhythm, in other words, it's something for them to dance to. But it seems to me you put such a lot in your lyrics. Does it bother you that Jamaica people don't hear your lyrics as well as they should? Or you think that they understand them and your message is getting across?
Well, I say many shall be called, but only few chosen, right? And then the people have listened for the trumpet, which is not no trumpet to a complete. Man of God talks, his imperial majesty, earth rightful ruler.
Now, Bob, a lot of recording artists have come on the show, and a lot of them have talked in very bad terms about record producers in Jamaica and about the record industry in Jamaica generally. Now, you have been in it from, you know, a couple of years well now.
Yeah.
What is your opinion of the situation now?
In Jamaica, and the recording scene in Jamaica, well, I think we're having a nice revolution because plenty of youth doing recording. Who never knows that they don't do recording? You know what I mean? So really, right now, we love what's going on.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah. But when you first started out, did you ever have any bad experiences with record producers?
Well, yes, but that is what caused the revolution today. Uh-huh. Because the truth them treat we so bad at them time. You see, the word spread around, say, the producer treat you bad. That mean all artists start do things for themselves, and man do things for like suffer and get it together down at the ghetto. Mm-hmm. And the guys them who have them big studio and drafts, well, then them is middle class and this, and we can only come to them studio, come chat to them and do a tune and get a £20. All of them things, they get a beaten. Mm-hmm. And it's only opportunists that go through them tribulations right now. Because tribulations from both sides. Mm-hmm. For the youth when them come and for the guy when them get old.
Yeah. But listen, did you, when you were coming along in the business and you're having some bad experiences, did you ever feel at any time that you had had enough, that you would like to get out of this business? Or is it something that you cannot get out of?
Yeah, man, one time, getting out of the business is a different thing. Mm-hmm. But one time I feel like I should take up my arms, you know, mm-hmm. and do a thing, but just say, no, youth, cool, mm-hmm. because it's a race, you know?
Yeah.
And I glad say that's how it work out for a man. Them go have too much wickedness out there, you know.
Yeah. Tell me, now let's go to this business of your religion. You're a Rastafarian. How long have you been a Rastafarian?
How long have I been a Rastafarian? I am a Rasta man, you know. I stand Rasta. Mm-hmm. For say how long, it's like again you have to say from creation, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
If you can overstand it that way. Because you're 15 years, 10 years. It's not really so. It's from creation.
But you know, a lot of people in Jamaica, they hear about Rasta, they see Rasta, but yet a lot of things about it they do not understand. Could you explain to people exactly what it means being a Rastafarian?
I would say to the people, man, be still and know that His Imperial Majesty, Emperor Haile Selassie I of Ethiopia, is the Almighty. Now, anyone have anything to say, come up, come and say it, Lord, make me hear what them have to say. Now, the Bible says so, Babylon newspaper says so, and I and I, the children, say so. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah.
So I don't see what kind of more reveal our people want, more God for reveal to them. What them want? They want a white God. Well, God come black.
Mm-hmm. You know, listen, Bob.
Choo-choo.
But listen, you know, a lot of people have a feeling that a lot of guys who claim to be Rastas are really, as one song says, rascal.
Many shall be called, but only few chosen, you know. And they shall be sheep and wolf in sheep clothing. But I couldn't watch that this day because I have to live Rasta and no Rasta. I don't come to judge a man, just to leave our judgment unto him. So all the people who see a man out there and say, oh, him a go on like say him say my Rasta, who is them for say, oh, him a go on, so? When God say, leave our judgment unto him.
Yeah. But what do you think about all this crime and violence going on though as a Rasta?
Well, I don't think as all the crime and violence going on is last cause crime and violence. Well, I don't really, you know, I mean, you know what I mean? Earth, a forward to our creation was an earth for rest. It's a mind thing. Now, all the laws that we abide by and blah, blah, boom, 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 because we suffer. As any man can know that. Them laws that them have don't must be a must. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Which laws? You're speaking about any laws in particular?
Every law. The only law which is law, is the law of life, the law of live. Mm-hmm. Now dig this, a man build him city and him say, want these people for run it, and him want these people for live here. So no, me don't want get involved talking like me's a politician, now me want, you know what I mean? Me just want to talk about righteousness like civilian. Rightful rule and him run no wire fence.
Yeah. But am I right in assuming that Rastas do not believe in violence at all?
Rasta don't believe in violence, man. Rasta don't believe. Rasta know.
Yeah.
You see, when you believe, is that mash you up. Mm-hmm. You must know what you know.
Yeah. You know? All right. Now, one of the interesting things about you, right? Yes. You have reached a point in your career now where you're popular in England, you're popular in the United States, right?
Yeah.
Right. But you live in Jamaica. You move out quite often, but you live in Jamaica. Do you think, like, say, Jimmy Cliff, you're going to have to eventually shift and live somewhere else? You think you might have to go away to live?
Ooh,
you
I
know,
personally.
Yes, you personally, as you get more popular over there.
Within 2,000 years, mm-hmm. just say, you know?
Yeah.
Earth is Earth. Within 2,000 years, now it's 1,973. Like I say again, I don't understand this thing for no money business. Mm-hmm. This thing is, if Jap come in our heart and make it move, that I have to go in England, go say these things again, or say these things in America or Australia. I will have to go because I personally is a servant of His Imperial Majesty. Right. Not doing no hard work, just doing what Jah say I have to do.
Yeah.
And him get the power to play music and him get the inspiration to say the things and the people who him work to. Because I man know say, Jah in every living in every life. Now, some people are devil and some people are angel. Dig? Just leave all judgment unto him. Dig? So, you know, it's plenty of things. There's certain things a man have to really keep to himself and try to suss it out for himself, because you can say things at the time you say it, it's not so right, and maybe not. You know what I mean?
You have to really,
because it's things that thing with Jah teach every day, and sometimes you have to learn it. You have to know him, say.
Yeah.
You have to suss it out.
No, you know, you obviously, you have your religious faith, right? And you have your convictions. Do you get annoyed by people who don't understand what you're talking about? Do you get annoyed?
I'm sorry for the people who do not understand what you talk about, man. Because there be a great tribulations in time when they don't have to. And it's not, you know, you see, I personally know my heart can be hard as a stone and yet soft as water. You know what I mean? Then again, still sorry for the people who don't know His Imperial Majesty.
Yeah.
Because it's like my mother used to tell me, you know, people that go chop off and them want dead and can't dead in the judgment. And these days, yeah, are the judgment days. You know, only the fittest of the fittest shall survive.
Yeah.
Like what Marcus Garvey said.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And you just said, go.
But tell me now, as a Rasta, what is your feeling about being Jamaican?
Being Jamaican?
Yeah.
Well, being Jamaican, well, years gone on, Neville. Being Jamaican, I don't say being Jamaican, you know. I see myself as a Rasta, being Rasta.
Uh-huh.
You know? Yeah. So Jamaica is Jamaica. Africa is Africa. I'm an Rasta.
Uh-huh. You don't have any boundaries?
My boundaries? No, well, I must pick a place on earth where I know I must live. Uh-huh. And I know I want to live near my father. And my father live in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
So I must live where my father is.
Literally? In other words, literally you hope to go and live in Ethiopia someday?
I don't hope. We're going. Mm-hmm. And near.
Uh-huh.
This is 1973, going near to 74, uh-huh. Now, you know, and just say, before one of my word pass away, heaven and earth crash, dig. Mm-hmm. And him say I'm gone for prepare a place that where he is, I and I shall be there also.
But Bob, listen, every day nowadays you read about famine in Ethiopia. What you say to that now? Right.
Great.
Everybody
I say great. If you don't know God, you're going to suffer and dead. No God, no partial. Regardless where you're upon earth. If you're in Ethiopia, in him palace, and you don't know, say him is the Almighty, you suffer. Regardless where you're there, God no partial eye. No, I could have starved and suffered too, but I know Jah.
Bob, your career is at a time. You make the cover of Melody Maker in England. People talking about you in the States. You have good albums coming out. You're on a new record label, now, Island, no?
Yes, Island.
Are you satisfied with the contract with them?
Yeah.
Eh? Are you quite satisfied? Because
well,
I know you've had a hard time.
Satisfaction is a hard thing to get, you know. Yeah. And live to what you need to be satisfied.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, I'm comfortable. I know we can make a move in time. We make a move. And that's the most important thing.
Yeah. All right. So, that's the situation right now with you. Now, it's Bob Marley and the Wailers. You write such a lot of material for the group. You have such a lot to do with it. We heard of Diana Ross and the Supremes. And then we heard of Diana Ross by herself. Are you committed to the group?
Well, yes. The group is the Wailers. Well, for some reason, them say Bob Marley and the Wailers. I never tell no one to say that from no time at all. But maybe for some reason, them do it, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I man is a Wailers, you know. And you just say it rest.
I do rest, so.
Yes.
Okay, so what is the next move as far as your career goes? You have this album out, Burning. What
right
next?
Now,
what
the next thing is, right now, and I will play some music, you know, and just go and play some music until then. Until what happened, it just happened, because I and I don't plan, like, you know, because when man plans, I wipe out.
Right. But do you have any special tours coming up that you know of?
No, I don't right now. I don't know of no tours right now. But I know tours might possible as well as maybe no more tours.
I understand what you mean. All right, but what about songwriting? You write such a lot of music. Different people write music in different ways. Some sit down and write the words and then put the music to it. Some write the music, then drop in the words after. Do you have a process? And exactly what is it, if you have one?
Well, it grew together, you know. It's like, first time I tried to write a song was the first time I tried to play the guitar. And so, I can't write a song without the guitar. But it really grew together. I really just not like steered my guitar, you know. But it just happened. It's just inspiration come through, man, you know. And I personally could write a woolly tune, it look like, you know, but I pick special tune for write.
Yeah.
Because a man can think of plenty of things, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yes, I understand. Hey, listen, you know, I know you had a close association with Johnny Nash, who has done quite a lot of your tunes. And we hear people talking and say, boy, I wonder if Johnny Nash ever treats our Jamaican man right. What exactly is the situation? We're quite free on this program.
Well, them give me some money the other day, you know, and I'm going to sign an agreement with them, and I'm really going to check it out, like,
yeah.
You know, because, you know, it's like, we don't want to say nothing bad about them, and still we don't have nothing much good for say.
Right. But what do you think about Americans taking the reggae and doing it and making big money out of it, like Johnny Nash has done, and Paul Simon, and a couple other people? What do you think about that?
Well, them do something which you, these people out here, I try to kill way off. We couldn't do, right?
Uh-huh.
Because them people out here too wicked.
Yeah.
No, never. Them things make me vex, like, you know.
I understand.
You know what I mean?
I can understand, yeah.
Because look how much good artists in Jamaica. You know what I mean? And look what it take for a guy just say, because them is guys, say, alright, I could get some good recording done and do a thing with it. Mm-hmm. Just a hustle of people when you come to 15 tune in 3 hours.
Yeah.
You know? And so a guy spend $15,000 to make a album. And when the album come, it sell a million.
Yeah.
So him don't lose because he really stay there. He don't guess nothing. Him stay there and do him that do.
Yeah. So you mean that the people here wouldn't spend the money on us?
Them never want to do
I
that.
I see, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Them wait till when time Johnny Nash and them guys go on with that thing and certain guys, them say, well, if a guys are coming now and them hardly even want to do it.
Yeah, yeah.
We have the one studio and all of that where we are going to try to get right now one studio.
All right, but
because we want it, Jamaica, we have it.
You want a studio?
Yeah, that's because we want to make music. You have too much man out there. We have to go through too much other things just to classes, you know.
You spoken a couple of times about classes, middle class.
Yes,
everything.
Because I'm come to realize,
them
really divide between classes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, and it's true. Them try for divide between classes where we don't agree with.
Yeah.
Guys, wickedness, you can't divide the people. Or you can you divide the people? And some of them are 4 foot.
Yeah. True. Listen, Bob, we run out of time, but I'd just like to ask you if you have any sort of hope in the country, Jamaica, right now. You're a guy who's getting on all right in your field, you know, in singing.
Hope in the country?
Yeah.
Well, yes, Jamaica is a nice, great place. I really love Jamaica, you know, because I walk plenty of stone land in Jamaica and plenty of hills. But I think
yes.
Really need a direction. Not a big old signing up this and signing up that, but a direction in your own country where warm to the earth. I mean, we have to till the soil and plant back the seeds in the soil, you know, and you know, call for slavery for do that.
Well, at least
you just call for understand.
You have made a start because you said you are a farmer.
I'm not a farmer, I say, from creation.
Okay. Bob Marley, it's been a great pleasure talking with you.